إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah and the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every misguidance and every going astray is in the hellfire. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, you and your families are well and healthy. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we seek refuge with Him from leprosy and madness and degenerative diseases and every evil harm and illness. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام ومن سيء الأسقام. Inshallah, we wanted to continue with this adhkar and dua series to memorize, especially the ones of the morning and the evening. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. Allah says, what means, O you who have believed, remember Allah with much remembrance and exalt Him in the morning and the afternoon. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحْ بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what means, and remember your Lord much and exalt Him with praise in the evening and the morning. So these ad'iyah of the morning and the evening, these adhkar of the morning and the evening, they have a special place in Islam to help protect us from harm, to protect us from evil, to protect us from every type of su. And so these are ones that we should be saying every morning, every evening, inshallah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who remember Him in the mornings and the evenings. And we remember the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, where he said, if you could hear the sound of the pens of the angels writing your name down along with those who remember Allah, you would die out of joy. And we hope and pray that the malaika witness us and record us and go back and mention us to Allah, although He knows everything with regarding this. So continuing on with this series, inshallah, we're going to have a couple today. One, the first one is just an evening dua, as you can see it on the screen. Abu Huraira, he narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من قال حين يمسي ثلاث مرات أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق لم يضره حمّةً تلك الليلة. This hadith, which is sahih in the Sunnah of Tirmidhi, the Prophet ﷺ said, whoever says three times when he reaches the evening. So this seeking refuge, this adhkar, is just for, this dhikr is just for the evening time, inshallah. And again, we mentioned the evening is after the Asr prayer. According to some of the scholars, it's after Maghrib time comes in, then that's fine as well. But whoever says this three times when he reaches the evening, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق, I seek refuge in Allah's perfect words from the evil of what He has created. I seek refuge in Allah's perfect words from the evil of what He created. Whoever says this three times in the evening, no poisonous sting shall harm him or her that night. One of the narrators, Suhail, he said, so our family used to learn it and they used to say it every night. And a girl amongst them was stung and she did not feel any pain from it. So this dua is to be said three times in the evening only, inshallah, again, after Asr, or before sunset, or even after sunset is fine if you didn't get to it, inshallah, and may Allah accept it. We have to always remember, especially in these times, my brothers and sisters in Islam, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلُوا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran what means, or do you think that you will enter paradise without such trials as came to those before you? They were afflicted with severe poverty, they were afflicted with ailments, and were so shaken that even the messenger and those who believed along with him said, when will the help of Allah come? Yes, indeed, certainly the help of Allah is near. So we should always remember that these calamities that befall us, they are in a book of decrees from before our existence. قَالَ اللَّهُ مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِّن قَبْلِ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Allah said what means that no calamity befalls on the earth or in yourselves, but it's inscribed in a book of decrees before we bring it into existence. Verily, that is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we should know this and we should remember, وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ, that whoever believes in Allah and accepts those calamities by the will of Allah, then Allah will guide his or her heart. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this of them, inshaAllah. So this dua, أَعُوذُ بِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ التَّامَّاتِ مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ, this should be said upon entering the evening. Again, after Asr time, right before sunset, or even after Maghrib comes in, inshaAllah. And you should say this three times in the evening. So definitely, you, your family should get on board with saying this one. The next narration that I wanted to mention also deals with something to do in the evening, and the adhkar to do in the evening and the morning. So this next one is for both times again, like the previous weeks were for both the morning and the evening. In this narration from Abdullah ibn Khubayb radiallahu anhu, he said, we went out on a rainy and intensely dark night to look for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to lead us in prayer. And when we found him, he asked, have you prayed? But I did not say anything. So he said, say, but I did not say anything. He said again, say, but I did not say anything. He then said, say. So I said, what am I to say? So he said to him again, فقلت يا رسول الله ما أقول قال قل هو الله أحد والمعاوذتين حين تمسي وحين تصبح ثلاث مرات تكفيك من كل شيء. So the rest of the narration goes, when he says, what am I to say, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam responded, say, قل هو الله أحد, say, he is Allah the one, meaning read Surah Al-Ikhlas, and the Mu'awadatan, the two, قل أعوذ برب الفلق and قل أعوذ برب الناس, recite them three times in the morning and in the evening, they will serve you for every purpose. They will serve you for every purpose. So Surah Al-Ikhlas is Surah number 112, Surah Al-Falaq, Surah number 113, and Surah Al-Nas, Surah 114. You read these three times every morning after Fajr and every evening after Maghrib prayer, or again, if you do it before, inshallah, this says to read these three times entering the morning and the evening, and they will serve you for every purpose you have. Such an easy thing for us to do, to get our scales of goodness have heavy weights on them on the day of judgment by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look, on top of that, they will serve you for every purpose, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these three surah have special meanings, and we know them from other proofs. We'll mention something briefly here to complete it. Bas Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, he reported that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أيعجز أحدكم أن يقرأ في ليلة ثلث القرآن؟ قالوا وكيف يقرأ ثلث القرآن؟ قال قل هو الله أحد تعدل ثلث القرآن. This hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, is any one of you capable of reciting a third of the Quran in a night? So the companions asked, how could somebody recite a third of the Quran in a night? Yani, we know it's like 30 juz', imagine like 10 juz', a third of the Quran. Upon this, the Prophet ﷺ said, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ, say, He is Allah the One. Surah Al-Ikhlas, he said, this is equivalent to a third of the Quran, subhanAllah. So, we see the heaviness and the weight of this surah and why if somebody recites it, then this will serve him or her, inshallah. So again, recite it three times in the morning and in the evening. Also mentioned was Surah Al-Falaq and Surah Al-Nas, where Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said in a hadith that is authentic in Jami'at, in Sunan Al-Tirmidhi, from Uqba bin Amr Al-Juhani, radiallahu anhu, he narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قَدْ أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ آيَاتٍ لَمْ يُرَى مِثْلُهُنَّ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ إلى آخر السورة وَقُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ إلى آخر السورة. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Allah has revealed to me ayat, the likes of which have not been seen before. He said, say, I seek refuge in Allah, in the Lord of mankind. This is قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, to the end of the surah. And say, I seek refuge in the Lord of the dawn, al-falaq, until the end of the surah. So in this hadith, we see the elevation of these ayat in Surah Al-Falaq and Surah Al-Nas, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, that Allah revealed those ayat and the Prophet ﷺ said, there is nothing the likes of which have not been seen. This is something the likes of which has not been seen before. Again, subhanAllah, showing the greatness of those. And Aisha, in a hadith in the Sahih of Al-Bukhari, she mentioned the hadith that whenever the Prophet ﷺ became sick, he would recite the Mu'awadhat, Surah Al-Falaq and Surah Al-Nas, and he would blow in another narration also mentions Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, and he would read them while blowing his breath over his body. And when he became seriously ill, in this hadith from Aisha and Sahih al-Bukhari, it just mentions Surah Al-Falaq and Surah Al-Nas, that whenever Allah's Messenger ﷺ became sick, he would recite the Mu'awadhat, Surah Al-Falaq and Surah Al-Nas, and then blow his breath over his body. When he became seriously ill, she said, I used to recite these two surahs and rub his hands over his body, hoping for its blessings. So again, these last three chapters, as you could say, at the end of the Quran, Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, Surah Al-Falaq, and Surah Al-Nas, these are protections from every harm and every evil, and they are enough for those who read them, and they will serve you for every purpose, insha'Allah, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. The other narration we mentioned is that sometimes the Prophet ﷺ, when laying in his bed, would read Surah Al-Ikhlas, Surah Al-Falaq, and Surah Al-Nas into the palm of his hands, and then wipe over the whole body, starting with the head and wiping down the right side and left side till he could reach, and he would do this three times as well. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, again, we are sharing very beneficial information, alhamdulillah, that we want to, inshallah, implement into our daily lives, the adhkar, these dua for the morning and the evening. We should memorize them, get the family together, especially at this time with the coronavirus, and we're locked up in our homes and we can't be in our beautiful and blessed masajid. May Allah return us back to them, inshallah. But these are the times to take benefit and not become lazy and not just resort to finding any type of entertainment and the likes of those matters, but take this time to memorize these remembrances, to call upon Allah, to seek refuge with Him in His perfect words from every evil that was created, and to recite these surah these chapters that Allah revealed that will serve us for every purpose. This is printable on the Islamic Center of Manteca website, icomanteca.org, and you will see a link for the morning and the evening dua in the upper left-hand portion of the screen of the website. Anything I said incorrectly is from me and Shaytan. If I said anything beneficial, it's by Allah's permission and will. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك واشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.